What's up, boys and girls? I am Mr. Vaca, and welcome to our Nintendo Club. So yesterday, Nintendo invited me to a very special private Nintendo Labo event where we got to try the vehicle kit coming out later this September. I just want to thank Nintendo again and the reps that were there at the event yesterday for making it such a fun and exciting experience. So what we're gonna do for this video is I'm gonna share some of the footage and I'm gonna talk about some of the brand new features that this vehicle kit brings to the Nintendo Labo family of toy cons. Once we got to New York City, we met up with our awesome friends, Danny and Philia, the Nintendo power couple. Then once we got to the event, our Nintendo Club students, Tommy and Hannah, were waiting there ready to go. And then we got to meet Ray and his awesome girlfriend, Chrissy, who we know from the BenQ projector giveaway. It was so great to finally meet them. Then we all sat down in the main event room and we got ready to learn about our agenda for the day. The first thing that we were going to do is build the key. The key is instrumental for all three vehicles, the submarine, the four-wheeler, and the airplane. Overall, it only took about 10 minutes to put the key together, and we were ready to get started. The Nintendo reps already had everything else built and ready for us to go. The other extremely important Toy-Con that you will be building in this vehicle kit that is necessary along with the key for all three vehicles is the gas pedal. You will be using this for, again, the plane, the car, and the submarine. Once we finished building the key, we took our right Joy-Con and put it inside the key. That's where the infrared camera is located. Then we took our left Joy-Con and put that into the gas pedal. If you wanted to drive the car, you put the key right into the middle of the wheel. If you wanted to switch to the airplane, you took the key out and put it into the middle of the flight stick. And if you wanted to drive the submarine, you just did the same thing, took the key out of the flight stick and put it into the controls of the submarine. The left Joy-Con stays in the pedal and doesn't need to be taken out depending on which vehicle you are using. Once we became familiar with the controls, we were off to explore the huge open world on our own. It was extremely easy to change on the fly between the car or the plane, and once we found some water, we quickly jumped into the submarine to start exploring. Now let's talk about that open world setup. There were different areas, maybe 7 or 8 possibly, don't quote me exactly on that. But each section had a ton of different missions based on the environment that you were in. For example, we would start in the forest area and one of the objectives was to cut down 5 trees. Another objective once we made it to the desert area was to get to the top of a pyramid. And then once we were in the lake section, we had to somehow figure out how to get to the sunken treasure chest. The cool thing was that these challenges came up through exploring. We didn't really know exactly what we had to do. We were just having fun going around the world. And then as we found a new area, these new challenges would pop up. I asked the Nintendo rep if there was a way that we could see all the challenges available for the entire game. And they said, not at this time, we would just have to explore. After about 20 to 25 minutes of exploring this huge open world, our Nintendo rep then showed us a new feature for the vehicle kit called the spray can. This is a new way to customize all three of your vehicles. You could change the propeller of your plane, the wheels of your car, or even the body of your submarine by taking this spray can, turning the top knob any way that you want to change the color, and then spraying it right on the screen to make it your own special design. After we customized our vehicles, we were then introduced to another new feature called the battle system. The battle mode reminded me a lot of the robot kits versus mode, where you have 2 players, but this time instead of robots, each player is in control of a car. There's different power-ups that you can use, and your objective is to knock the other player off the course. These battles were heated. It was so much fun to watch our Nintendo Club students try to knock each other off, and even watching Danny and Philia trying to have a battle with their huge punching arms popping out of the cars. It was hilarious. I can't wait to play this again when it comes out on September 14th. After those crazy battles, we needed a little break, and this break was called the Discovery Break. And just like in the Variety Kit and the Robot Kit, after you make
and play with your vehicles in the Labo kit, you then get to discover. The coolest thing about this discover section is that it taught you how to build duplicates of, say, like the pedal, without having the cardboard cutout that the Labo kit provided. So for example, say you wanted to have four pedals for a four-player game. You could build it using spare cardboard, maybe a tape roll, some paper and string. There were endless ideas, well, depending on your creativity, on how you could duplicate every single component of this vehicle kit. It honestly blew my mind. And behind me, we had two of our teachers here at Brought School, and I loved how they were saying, oh, look at how this could be in our STEAM project, or that's a cardboard challenge project right there. They were so excited. It was so inspiring to see our staff working with the Nintendo staff and seeing what they could create and how it could be used in our school. It was incredible. After we finished our discovery lesson, it was time for the final event, the four-person slot car race. Okay, so let me explain this brand new mode. The Nintendo rep had set up four pedals, one for each player. All you had to do was press the gas pedal down, and that would determine how fast your car would go. You didn't have to worry about steering, but what you did have to pay attention to is how fast you would go around the turns. If you were going too fast, your car would fall off the side and fall back in the race. Our first race was Danny, Felia, Hannah, and Tommy, and it was hilarious. Our Nintendo Club students put us to shame. I even tried to jump in, and I got destroyed. All of the different modes that we got to see, such as the battle mode and the slot car mode, were extremely fun to play with another person. It's the perfect couch co-op Labo experience so far that they have created. I'm still kind of blown away and in shock with how genius the new Discover section was in Labo. They were giving us step-by-step directions on how to create another pedal using everyday items in the house. This kit is truly going to ignite your imagination and creativity to a whole new level. There's only one recommendation that I have for Nintendo. That's when you are in the car and you need to fill up your gas tank. All of the attendees that were older didn't have an issue filling up the gas tank, but my Nintendo Club students, again, who are only 6 years old, had a lot of difficulty trying to get the car positioned perfectly so that it could fill up the gas tank and needed assistance every time. But when you think about it, it really isn't too much of a complaint because it's going to practice their driving skills. You had to learn how to back up the car and which way you turned the wheel affected where the car went. And so, you know, maybe it wouldn't be easy right from the get-go, but overall it's kind of a benefit in the long run. And then that was it. Our event was over and it was time to go home. I don't think anyone really wanted to go home. We all kind of hung out in the lobby for like a half an hour afterwards, just talking about how much fun that event was and how excited we are to get our hands on this kit when it comes out in just a few short weeks on September 14th, 2018. Thank you again so much, Nintendo, and to the reps for everything. You seriously made memories that are going to last a lifetime, and we can't thank you enough. So don't forget, hit that subscribe button, notification bell, and most importantly, work hard, play hard. See y'all next time.